feeling well. This is going to be your reading. So the first card you got is the Dark Lady. And often when I see this, if I'm just intuitively reading, I'm like, you know, dark energy, this and that. Actually, this is similar to the High Priestess type energy, as in you are actually very powerful. You can pick up on all sorts of energy. You're in touch with this power that you have here. This also does represent that you have come through a lot. You don't get to this powerful position having a fairy tale life. You know, you probably got the crappy end of the stick many times in your life and had to find your way through that, okay? So what this is talking about with the Friends card at the bottom is actually about retreating and taking time away, possibly from others, taking time to yourself, to surrender, to allow other energies to come in, okay? Oh my gosh, look what card just came out. The lover, I wasn't even looking when it was coming out. You got the Lovers, to allow other, not another person, to allow love in, possibly the one that you're dealing with right now. I do feel that you're very open, you're very secure, and you even don't mind being vulnerable. Sorry if I'm a little stuttery. It is what it is. You don't mind being vulnerable, okay? Which is something that someone with this amount of power has to be. So let's see what card here we have. Oh my gosh, Queen of Wands. So Capricorn, you may be waiting for someone to return to you. Or expecting someone to return, a love interest here. You may know this is going to happen. This may be a situation that hasn't been the easiest for you. Look at that, Two of Swords. There may have been times when you were unsure about this, but I do feel that now you are in your power knowing this is going to happen. Okay, so let's see what else. What's going on? What's this storyline about? Oh, okay, so we might be dealing with a water sign here, Nine of Cups. I do feel, and I was actually, the other card I was going to pull is the Nine of Pentacles. I do feel that this is someone that will be single when they come to you. They will be ready to participate with you, ready to offer you some sort of happiness here. Let's see what else. This is a very jolly person is what I want to say. Look at no fights, no fighting, something like that. No arguing with this person. They find solutions, they make things happen, and there's patience within this person. So this person may have been waiting for something to end. I am seeing the Three of Swords here. This person may have been waiting to get out of a situation before they could come towards you, which is very possible. This person makes suffering look good. Okay, I'm going to put it like that. Even if this person was going through some stuff, they keep their presence very very well, okay? They maintain this energy and this presence of happy-go-lucky very well. So the communication is here, yeah. What's going on? What's causing this communication? Let's see what's happening. So yeah, this person is being called towards you. This person is finally realizing that they want to come forward. It could also be that this person may be getting out of a situation, a karmic situation. The karmic situation could literally be about anything, especially with this Four of Swords energy. This can be about literally anything, but it looks like it's possibly something from the past, whether it be a past relationship that's ending. It does look like it's something from the past. It could also be childhood with the Six of Cups here. So it could be about a past relationship or childhood. Okay, let's see what's coming out. So I do think you're dealing with someone who's put a lot of effort into something. And maybe it was even a lot of effort to change their life. This person is very hardworking, has a lot of investments. I mean, these are all descriptions. What does this person want with you? A new beginning, the World card. This person wants happiness with you. This person wants a fresh start. And I do feel like, you know, you're going to hear this person out. Okay, let's see what else we have coming out here. A Sun card. I mean, Capricorns, this is a beautiful reading. It doesn't really get better than that. Let's dig in, though. Let's just dig in. See what these cards are going to bring up, and then maybe we'll have something else to clarify besides, look at abundance. Well, Caps, I mean, you have something great on the way. Keep a positive mindset to get exactly what you want. This is about, you know, the rising phoenix, the love call, someone calling you, wanting to return, the dragonfly. You're going to get what you want. Just stay in the energy of gratitude and bliss. And I mean, if you wanted to even say that this may have had to do with money, well, then you're going to get a lot of money coming in. Okay, regardless. The sword and the stone, clarity. Oh, sorry. Truth. Honor, solidarity. So whatever this person is coming in to speak on, they're going to be truthful, honorable, obviously. I don't know. I feel like this person does want to make some sort of a pact with you. Okay, so let's see what else we have. Take that away. Take the one on the top. And it is self-indulgent. Focus on self-worth. Take time to heal. Self-appreciation. This is probably what you have been doing. So let's get into that. Oh, at the bottom of the deck, we have the Ace of Pentacles. So this is an offer. And it's interesting that I'm mentioning it could be about money. Like, this is obviously a love reading, but love and money can be tied together. So if any of you are like, oh, they're not happening, it's not happening. Well, something's coming in. Stay positive. So the self-indulgence I'm clarifying here, it looks like you went through a time. I'm hearing self-pity, and I don't think... Well, that's what I'm hearing. Okay. So there was like a little bit of a pity party. Oh, we didn't even flip these cards over. How did I not see those? So, relationship evolving to the next phase, healing the inner child, not dealing hurt. So yeah, I think you did go through a lot of healing, and you're possibly almost like, you know, I'm not going to deal with that crap anymore. I'm going to respect myself, love myself, and feel good, okay? So let's go back to this, though. But it looks like you were hanging on to something. You were hanging on to energies that you had to have the strength to let go of. What was that about? What happened here? Maybe because this person was coming in and out of your life, you know, not sticking around, coming in, running out. You had to really end that energy, that's for sure, or end, like, the sorrow that you were feeling because of that. So this could have all been internal work you did here. Let's see what else we have coming up. So we have the Page of Pentacles and yeah, the Seven of Wands. It's like you chose to stop fighting with the BS, okay, and have a new beginning. Now, if this is your person here, this is them putting down the battle and coming in for a new beginning. Either way, there's a new beginning happening here, and it's actually going to be solid this time around. Someone is going to put the work into this. This person could be fully single now, by the way, because I'm just getting that Nine of Pentacles energy. This person could be walking away from something else that they were putting a lot of effort into and coming for a fresh start. I mean, that's actually very possible here, especially with the Star card. So let's get a couple more cards for Capricorn and let's see what's going on here. Patience and planning and sacrifice. So I feel personally like this is what was going on behind the scenes, because here we have the new beginning now. We even have this truth energy of like taking that step, having that true new beginning. But I feel that, you know, during this time, whatever was going on, there was patience that was needed. Someone did have to make a plan, and there may have been sacrifice waiting for this to happen. But, I mean, as it's showing, something good is coming your way, and I feel it's this person. I feel it's this person coming in. So, let's get one more card here, and then I'm going to go into the extended if you want to join. Every now and then, I'm going to be doing extendeds, and it may be more often than you know, so I may just, I don't know. Anyhow, we have the Three of Swords here, so there was heartache involved in this, okay? And we have the King of Gems here. I do feel like this person has a lot of money. Six of Shells, this is most likely the person from your past that you have a lot of wonderful memories of, but I do feel that this person had to make a choice, or this person, this King of Gems energy. I mean, it could be you, Capricorns, right? But look, even here's the Nine of Gems and the Moon. I feel like this person is I don't know. They're coming in, okay? There's going to be a change. They're making a choice. They hurt you in the past. And let's leave it at that for now. I'm going to ask in the extended, is this person leaving a marriage or something? I am seeing a Queen of Wands sticking out. But anyhow, Caps, thank you so much for joining me. And I hope that you got some sort of info from this reading. Bye for now.